I hope you're ready for rhythm workout number 2.
Before we start our rhythm workout, make sure that you have printed out this week's rhythm cards. If you don't have a printer, you can stop this video right now and copy down rhythms 1 to 6 for yourself. The other rhythms can wait for a later time. In our last lesson, we used different combinations of quarter notes and 2/8 notes connected by a beam to make rhythmic accompaniments to songs in 4/4 time. As a reminder, in 4/4 time, there are 4 beats in a measure. That's what the top number tells you. And the bottom number stands for the quarter note. And in 4/4 time, the quarter note gets 1 beat. If you are still a little shaky with 4/4 time, please go back to rhythm workout number 1 and continue playing those rhythms until you are comfortable with them. However, if you are feeling secure with 4/4 time, welcome to rhythm workout number 2, 3/4 time. Here is what the time signature for 3/4 time looks like. If you notice, the bottom number is still a 4. That's because the bottom number stands for the quarter note. So that means the quarter note will get 1 beat. But the top number has changed. Now we have a 3 instead of a 4. The 3 stands for 3 beats in a measure. So that means in each measure, there are only 3 beats. Composers love to write songs in 3/4 time. We call songs in 3/4 time waltzes or minuets. Perhaps you know this famous minuet by Ludwig von Beethoven. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Or maybe you know this waltz by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now, before our rhythm workout begins, we'll learn a wonderful song about New York City that is written in 3/4 time. It's called The Sidewalks of New York. The video will tell you the history of the song and also show you some pictures of children playing in New York City around the time the song was written. Then we'll sing the song, and after we're done singing, we'll play some rhythms in 3/4 time.
East side, west side, all around the town.
One summer afternoon, as the 19th century came to a close, an Irish-American vaudeville singer named Charles Lawlor asked his friend James Blake, a salesman in a hat shop, to come up with the lyrics for a tune that had been rattling around in his head for some time. Something about New York, Lawlor said. Between serving customers, Blake found himself thinking of the old neighborhood on 18th Street, where he had grown up, and of the people he had known there. Jakey Krause, the baker, and his friend Little Jimmy Crow, and Mamie O'Rourke, who had first taught him how to dance. Set to the lovely lilting two-step Lawlor had composed, Blake's haunting memories of the sidewalks of New York would go on to become an enormous hit across the country, and one of the most popular songs ever written about New York City.
Side, west side, all around the town. The tots and ring a rosy, London Bridge is falling down. Boys and girls together, me and Mamie O'Rourke, trip the light fantastic on the sidewalks of New York. Side, west side, all around the town. The tots and ring a rosy, London Bridge is falling down. Boys and girls
and Mamie O'Rourke. Trip the light fantastic on the sidewalks of New York.
Let's sing the sidewalks of New York. I'll sing a line and you be my echo. Here we go. East side, west side. All around the town, the tot sang ring a rosy. London Bridge is falling down. Boys and girls together, me and Mamie O'Rourke, trip the light fantastic on the sidewalks of New York.
Now let's sing along with the one and only Nat King Cole.
East side, west side, all around the town, the tots sang ring a rosy, London Bridge is falling down.
Now we're going to do the most important rhythm, rhythm number one for the whole song. Now don't forget, the first beat is the strong beat, and beats two and three, they're the weaker beats. And for the strong beat, because it's nice and loud, I'm going to use a clap. And for the weaker beats, I'm going to use two pats. So it's one, two, three, one, two, three. East side, west side. One, two, three, one, two, three. And while you're doing it, as you get comfortable, you can style it a little bit. And. Now we're going to put a combination together. I'm choosing card one for the first part of the combination and card three for the second part of the combination. So I'll do eight measures of card one, then eight measures of card three, then I'll go back to card one, and I'll go back to card three. And for card one, we're going to keep the same clap, pat, pat, clap, pat, pat. Now card three, it's ta, ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Rose, tulip, rose, rose, tulip, rose, rose, tulip, rose. So for that really strong first beat, instead of using a clap, I'm going to use a stamp. And then I'll do the second and the third beats using my pat function. So it's stamp, and then tulip, rose. So it's rose. rose, tulip, rose, rose, tulip, rose. Ta, ti, ti, ta. Ta, ti, ti, ta. Ta, ti, ti, ta. Ta, ti, ti, ta. The tricky part is making the transitions between the two rhythms. But I'll help you out. Okay? Here we go. Number one. Three, four, five, six. Get ready. Okay, change to three. Get ready, we're going back to one and four, five, six, seven. Get ready for the change and so for this lesson, I'm going to use my chopsticks as my beaters. And I've got to figure out from my drum, which is going to be the strong beat, which drum head, and which drum head will be the two weaker beats. So ta, 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 rose, 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 rose. So let's listen here. Which is going to be the best one for the low sound? I don't know about you, but I'm going to choose that to be the strong one, and these will be my two weaker beats. So it'll be ta, ta, ta. All right, let's put on the music and see how we do. I'm going to play rhythm number two on my old friend, the bucket drum. And once again, we have three beats. And this time, the first beat is those joined eighth notes right there. So it's ti-ti-ta-ta, ti-ti-ta-ta, or tulip, rose, rose, tulip, rose, rose. And it sounds like this. Tulip rose, rose, tulip rose, rose, tulip rose, rose, tulip rose, rose. So let's find out how number two sounds as the rhythm underneath the sidewalks of New York. Titi ta ta, titi ta ta. Here we go. If you found any of those rhythms difficult, please rewind the video and practice them again. And now you're ready to keep the rhythm to songs in 3/4 meter as well as in 4/4 meter. You can use the rhythms on the cards or create your own rhythm accompaniments. Happy music making!